Climbers on Mount Everest are facing new rules as the Nepalese government tries to control overcrowding and the impact on the environment that thousands of visitors leave every year. The size of teams will be limited, human waste must be taken back to base camp, and climbers must carry tracking devices after 17 people died last year alone. Alexander Hillary is from the Himalayan Trust and is also Sir Edmund Hillary's grandson. He joins us now from Wanaka. Good morning, Alexander. What do you make of these new rules?
Thanks for having me, Anna. Look, I think it's a great thing. You know, in New Zealand, we know what it means to be strong advocates for our whenua, and I think this is what we're seeing in Nepal right now. You know, Sherpa and Nepali people, they're wanting to preserve the natural beauty of this alpine environment. So for anyone that has visited the Himalayas, you know, you'll understand that it is absolutely mind-blowing. There's nowhere else like it in the world. But it is fragile, it's changing, and it's amazing that the local people, the communities, have the voice, they have the education and the means to sort of stand up for their home.
I've got to say, I mean, I have not been to the Himalayas, let alone to base camp, and I'm surprised that one of the rules is now a ban on spas, bakeries and cafes at base camp. I just didn't even realise that they were even allowed at base camp. So what sort of impact has that level of tourism had on the area or on the region, environmentally or otherwise?
Well, look, you know, Mount Everest has been an amazing thing for Nepal. It has definitely changed the livelihoods of the entire region and the country, you know, at a wider scale. It's an amazing tourism industry, and there are a lot of people that want to visit the tallest mountain in the world. So, yeah, you know, the Sherpa people, they're resourceful. They've come up with all sorts of business ventures. And look, it's up to the Nepal to shape the mountain into what they want it to be. You know, we're facing similar challenges here in New Zealand with Piopiotahi Milford Sound. And we need to look at, you know, we can't, it's a taonga for the country. We can't just shut it off, but we need to shape it in a way that, you know, so it is something that we want it to be.
Some of these rules are obviously designed to deliberately manage the number of people or the size of groups obviously going up there. And I'm surprised that these rules are only just coming in now. Have they been late to fruition in terms of, you know, things like having to carry a tracking device?
Yeah, look, we're really lucky to have pristine natural environments here in New Zealand. And for most of the world, finding that sort of balance in sort of resource management is really, really challenging. So something that I think not a lot of Kiwis will realise is Ed and the Himalayan Trust and the Department of Conservation here in New Zealand had a role to play in setting up Sagarmatha National Park, which is Mount Everest National Park. So Kiwis actually have a bit of a part in this sort of story, which is quite special. But I think it's about time, you know, that these changes start to happen, and Sherpas are starting to be leaders in this industry. They're running unbelievably successful businesses. They're some of the most experienced guides we have on the planet now, and they're taking responsibility for Mount Everest.
These rules obviously will be a bit of a change for climbers, particularly who have maybe made more than one attempt or more than one summit. Do you think that they will have issues with it? Are there going to be any complaints about what I would have thought was only reasonable, bringing down your human waste, for example?
I'm sure there'll be complaints, but I think they're all reasonable too. You know, we want to climb, you go to the mountains because they're an amazing place to visit. You don't want to be walking around in feces and rubbish. You know, the 54 metres of ice has melted off the South Cole Glacier in the past 25 years, and it's going to continue. You know, they call the Himalayas the third pole for good reason. There's a huge amount of ice there, and it's a very important part of the world. And as that ice melts, you know, waste, rubbish is going to start to appear from expeditions long gone from my father and dad's times. And, you know, I think we need to really shape up and change those practices.
Change for the better. Alexander Hillary joining us from Wanaka this morning. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks.